Hey there, hi there, everyone. All right, I have one more topic tonight, and that is working with lunar energy. And again, this is part of kind of a series on energy work that I wanted to go over this month. And I know there is a lot of information already out there on the different phases of the moon and working with those phases and what they mean, the correspondences. I'm sure a lot of people know a lot more about that than I do, so I'm not really going to talk a whole lot about that. I don't focus too much on the moon except very generally. You know, I have my full moon rites on the full moon. I try to do something on the new moon that's more introspective. I know that things grow when the moon is waxing and banishing is good when the moon is waning, but other than that, I am not an expert on lunar energies, so I highly recommend seeking out those who are. What I will talk about tonight is something specific to the new moon and new moon energies, because this was recommended to me a while back, I think the end of last year, by a friend. She and another friend of hers do this. They do it every month for the new year, the new moon. And they swear by it. They love it. So I looked into it, and basically, here's the deal. My friend recommended for me this book. It's called New Moon Astrology, and I think this is the reason I need to go back to using my camera. My camera doesn't make things backwards. But this is New Moon Astrology by Jan Spiller. And I originally checked it out of the library, and I liked it so much I got a used copy. And, of course, you can see I have all my tabs in here because it's very much a reference book. The first part, it's split into three parts. The first part actually talks about using the energy of the new moon. And then the other two parts are a lot of reference for specific things that she talks about. But the idea is that the new moon is a time of strong energy. And basically, if you use this time to make wishes, then you have a better chance of actually seeing those wishes materialize. And she goes over how to write the wishes, how to do them, how many to do, all of that. She's got a whole system down. But the reason this appealed to me was because I had heard this concept of new moon wishes before, and I thought it was adorable. I loved it. When I heard of it before, it was in the aspect of doing a new moon wishing ceremony of some sort, basically every quarter, once every third month or so. Or I've also heard of it doing them on the, like, the blue moon and the, what's the other one? An extra moon of some sort, but blue moon, extra moon, whatever. So I've heard about doing this on certain specific moons. This is the first time I heard about doing it on every new moon. And she goes through what each new moon is good for, what kind of wishes. So, long story short, I thought it was a fun idea, and I wanted to try it. So I think the first time I tried it was January of this year, and it stressed me out. I way overthought it, and I didn't like my wishes, and I didn't like how it turned out. I stressed out about it. So this time around, I decided, you know what? It is what it is. I'm not going to stress. And, oh, I think part of the issue was this is basically a time-bound thing. You're supposed to do your wishes preferably within 8 hours of the actual new moon, although you have up to 48 hours of effective time. So this time around, I said, you know, I'm just going to have fun with it. And even better than that, to not stress myself out, I am going to go through her list of suggested wishes for this moon, because the moon in whatever sign it was, and I'm just going to look at what resonates with me, what sounds good, and I'm going to either use that wish or use something similar. So I did. I made little marks in my book. I picked out the wishes that I wanted to work with. And I had so much fun with it this time around. Once I decided not to stress, it was great. I just went straight through. I picked out different things. And I keep promising blog posts, but I will have a companion blog post because I did take a couple of pictures of what I did along the way, of how I organized my wishes. And now here's the other thing. You have to write down your wishes. So I used this little notebook that I had because I've had it for a while. I just thought it was cute. And I wrote my wishes in here. And you're supposed to hang on to them. You don't have to look at them again. Once you make your wish, that's it. It's in the universe and you don't have to fuss with it. But it is good to hang on to them. She tells you not to get rid of them because this way, as things start to manifest, you can see how it relates to the wishes you made and see what's working, what isn't, which is a nice concept. Last thing on this for this specific moon, because it's the new moon in Aries, and it's, I believe, the first new moon after the spring equinox. This is important because she says this is an especially magical time, and she suggests doing a treasure map. It's a vision board. Basically, do a vision board for your wishes for the year. And I have been wanting to do a little project like that anyway for a while because I think it would be fun. And I had something going like that for another project I was doing. So I said, okay, I'll do a little treasure map. So I gathered up what I needed. And I am not artistic. I love doing collages and things, but it's not, scrapbooking stuff is not my thing. So what I decided to do, especially also because I don't keep magazines around, I don't have anything I can cut up and paste onto a board. So I sat down, once I did my wishes, I sat down with my iPad and I created a Pinterest board. I looked up pictures for the things that I was wishing for this year. I put together a board, and then that was all I did at that point because I wanted to kind of close up my new moon activities. But I did tell myself, okay, I have a 48-hour window, so within this 48 hours, I'm going to complete this board. And I went back into Pinterest. I saved the pictures that I wanted, and I went into an online kind of something similar to Photoshop, but much easier. I mean, I was able to use it. I've never been able to use Photoshop. It's called Pixlr. I went into Pixlr and arranged all of these photos or the ones that I wanted into a collage. And then I saved that. I printed it out onto a basic 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And then here's what I did with it. So, and I will post a picture. I don't think this will show up very well because it's glossy. But here is my treasure map. And it has several things on here. They're all meaningful to me. And I really like how it came out. And so I had this all on one sheet. And what I did was on the back, I just pasted it to some cardstock, and I added things like this just tells you it's the treasure map and the date, new moon in Aries. And here I just have from Cinderella, a dream is a wish your heart makes, because I think that's cute. And this is actually a prayer to the moon maiden, and I got this from my Kuan Yin oracle cards. And I thought that this prayer really kind of encapsulated what I was thinking when I was putting this together. So what I did, I put this together, I cut it down the side, I had it laminated with a little space here, specifically so that I could fold it. I can fold it, I punched holes along the side, and I now have this for my planner. I keep it in my planner, so if I'm out and about, I have my planner, then I can look at it whenever I want. It also turned out nice enough that I think I might print up another copy just to keep on my wall because I think it's pretty. So I am just inordinately happy with how cute this turned out. I am so proud of myself because this is not a crafty thing that I normally would do a good job on, but I think it turned out really well. And that is that. That is how I have been trying to use the new moons so far. I really like the idea of using new moon energy to cast wishes. And I am kind of curious to see how my treasure map plays out during this year. So I hope that was fun for you and something a little bit new. Do check out that book. Highly recommend it. It's fun if you get a chance. And I will see you the next time. Bye.